show. A show based on the assumption that no matter who you are or how busy you are, you have at least one half hour to waste. And well, here's a man who's wasted at least half a century, my uncle, which is obviously the downside of working with a severely limited gene pool. But he's more than a woodsman. He's a kudsman, and in most cases, a shudsman. Anyway, here he is, the star of the Red Green Show, Mr. Red Green.
Thank you, Harold. Thank you, and welcome to Possum Lodge. You've already met my nephew, Harold, who's my brother's only child, which is certainly understandable.
I got a neat one for you here, Uncle Red. Look at this one.
Harold is responsible for the look of the show, so don't come complaining to me. But we got a fun show for you this week, although I must say I did start today with a rude awakening, which sounded actually like Stinky Peterson. But then when I got up and I washed my face and I noticed there was no towel, and then I noticed that my face wasn't wet, and then I noticed there was no water. And so I figure either the water pump is broken again or Possum Lake evaporated.
Uncle Red, has anybody told Helmet?
Well, I don't think that's necessary, Harold, because all you gotta do is be chewing on a cup of coffee and you realize that we're out of water. So the bunch of us were sitting around chewing on cups of coffee, and old man Sedgwick was, of course, sucking on a tea bag, and he was reminiscing about the good old days at the lodge, you know, before they had any of the modern amenities, you know, like a roof. And he said back then what they would do to make coffee is they'd go out and they'd gather up condensation off the grass in the morning, or as he put it, they made do. So we nailed him right on the scone with a waffle iron for that one.
But don't you think he had a point, though?
Well, he certainly does now, Harold. He's got about 36 little ones right up in here. But, okay, yeah, I guess we probably did appreciate things more, you know, back when the dinosaurs roamed the earth.
Did they even have, like, outhouses back then?
Yeah, they did, but there was no hole in them. Anyway, you know, once you get used to the modern things like a water pump or a sweeping compound, you know, it is very difficult to go back.
Well, I'm here to say that we're not going back. We're going forward because progress may be destructive and inhumane, but technology sure is neat, eh?
Well, unless it's a water pump.
Okay, I got this washer unthreaded. How's the urine, Bill? Any blockage? Okay, what do you say? You blow in that, and I'll see if the back pressure valve closes. Okay, keep blowing.
Helmet, I just turned on the sink, and all I got was this gurgling noise like Stinky makes, but no water came out. Is there anywhere in this lodge I can wash my hands? What am I asking you for?
You'll find Possum Lake the other end of that dock, or you can wait until I'm done fixing this pump.
I'll use the lake. And please, make me a list of everything that you touch. Especially food.
Helmet? Helmet, have you ever noticed that we seem to be having an inordinate amount of breakdowns? You know, I'm just, you know, like pipes and pumps and stoves and doors, you know. And, well, my TV equipment, it's a lot more complicated. And it hardly ever needs servicing, you know. Why do you think it is the infrastructure of this lodge is in constant need of repair? Why do you think that is?
Harold, this place is a dump filled with crap.
Okay, all righty. So what's the problem with the pump there, Helmet? Other than its crappiness.
It's either a seized bearing on the impeller shaft or the back pressure valve spring is fatigued.
So Mr. Pump's not feeling too well. And neither is Bill.
Well, so you're working on your water pump there, huh?
No. Harold, do you want to go scare me up some tin snips about 7 feet of shoe leather?
Alrighty. Is it okay if I get 7 feet of shoe leather from about 7 different pairs of shoes?
Well, glad to hear your water pump's working fine. Delighted, really, because, you know, we just dropped by to get ourselves a pail of fresh, cold water. Now, where would we find your nearest tap?
Okay, Murray, all right. The pump is broken.
Aw.
The question was, where's the tap? Don't you listen, Helmet?
Dwayne, the pump is broken. That means there is no water coming out of the taps, which means you don't need to know where the taps are.
Exactly. Told you.
Well, you're in luck today, Helmet. We're having a sale on water pumps down at the store.
We bought this one off you on sale.
Wow, such a good memory.
It's only been 6 weeks.
Our memory is as short as our warranty. That's our slogan. or is it our creed?
Red, I can sell you a brand new reconditioned water pump out of a Mack truck complete with conversion kit for only $150.
Maybe it's our motto. I can fix this one good as new for $100.
Well, what about you, Duane? What's your offer?
I could sell you a hot air corn popper for $14.95.
Well, I'm gonna have to think it over, guys. So I'll let you know later.
Well, by the time he thinks it over, Bill and I'll have this pump fixed.
Oh, well, I don't think so there. While you weren't looking, I got Duane to eat one of the parts.
Well, I guess when I scare up my tin snips, I'm gonna have to scare that part up too.
Got it.
My friend had a sliver in the back of his arm. It was big and huge and looked like it could cause him a great deal of discomfort at some future time. So I took my needle and my vice grips and my bottle opener. I proceeded to remove the sliver with the occasional break for refreshments. Well, I dug away at it for an hour or two. Can you imagine my embarrassment when my friend pointed out that it was actually a tattoo? Show you how to change your oil, or more specifically, how to change the oil on your car. It's something that you have to do every couple of years, and darned inconvenient. Plus, it can cost you upwards of $15. Besides, when you get it done at a gas station or whatever, you're just not sure whether or not they've done a bad job, you know, whereas if you do it yourself, you know. Okay, first thing you're gonna need is something to catch the oil with when you're taking the old oil out. I like to use one of these foil roasting pans. This is one I used to cook a turkey in last night in the microwave oven, which has actually created another handyman corner for us later in the season, how to fix your microwave. Next thing you need is an adjustable wrench. This is to loosen the nut drain plug on the bottom of the oil pan. And this is another handy little item here that I like. It's a creeper. It's got the wheels on the bottom, and you use that to lie down on and roll yourself under the vehicle. So, put the creeper in place, get our pan, we got our wrench, and under we go. Oh, okay, all right, here we go. Oh! Okay. How many of you handyman noticed my little trick there? I forgot to raise the jack, or pretended. I pretended. Yeah, that's it, yeah. Okay, so you go around to the jack, because you got to raise the car up to get under it. You know, any idiot knows that. So you set the jack to raise, it's like going to your boss and saying, hey, Jack, how about a raise? And up she goes. Boy, oh boy. Okay, we're getting there. I may need a longer jack. Oh. All right, golly. So, if the mountain won't come to Mohammed, get yourself one of these engine arm lift, one of these things. So, up she goes. What's happening here is that the car's coming up with the engine because the engine motor mounts are still done up, because you have to undo them from underneath, which we can't get underneath because we can't jack the car up. So we're right back to square one. So we have to revert to the laws of physics, which is, if we can't get the engine to come up, maybe we can get the car to go down. She went a little bit. OK, Okay, now, the reason the engine was so heavy was that we didn't bother with the time-consuming job of removing the transmission. So now what we can do is just take out the drain plug. Let me get our little pan here to catch the... And we're going to get the old oil out of her here. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. She's coming. Yeah. Okay, that's got her. Well, she was definitely ready for an oil change, wasn't she? Huh? Tighten that up again. And now we can put the new oil back in. I say new oil, but it's actually just the oil I took out of the thing last time I did the oil change. Okay, I'll take off some cap here. And we pour it right in here. Not gonna spill any there. And that's basically it for doing your oil change. It's that simple. Spill a little bit there, okay. There we go. All right. And that's it. So until next time, remember, the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. Oh, here we go. Now she can take a bit more. It is autumn. Hunting season opens today. Some say hunting isn't a sport. We have guns, the animals have nothing. But we know how to even up the odds. We give ourselves a handicap. It's called beer. Well, this water pump thing is causing a real stir around here. Douglas says we can't afford a new pump, but the old one's held together with string and chewing gum, which actually fluoridates the water somehow. But now Buster Hatfield and Old Man Sedgwick, they want to go back to the way things were with no water system and no telephone, no electricity.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Play Nintendo by candlelight? No, thank you.
You know, Harold, the simpler things are, the less there is to go wrong. At least that's the rule. You're the exception. Personally, I think we should let Helmut go ahead and try and fix the pump because he's got his mind set on it. And I don't really want to argue with anybody who's larger than my van.
You know, Uncle Red, I was down at Murray's store, and he says he'll sell us like a water pump that has a service plan and a warranty. Well,
does it include life insurance for you?
Well, why would I need that?
Because you're the one who'd have to tell Helmut.
No! No, you send somebody that nobody likes to do that.
Murray?
That's the one.
Yeah, you're looking pretty good there, Douglas.
Oh, hello, Red. Thank you. I'm just trying to keep the resale value up.
Yeah.
I'm not that I'd ever sell her.
No.
Now, when's the last time you waxed your van?
Well, I run into a beehive one time.
Well, it's a pride thing, Red. I take great pride in my car.
Well, that's tough to do with a Nash.
It's not a Nash, it's a gremlin. Is that your idea of a joke?
No, I think this is Detroit's idea of a joke.
Well, I'm not about to argue taste in cars with a man whose truck is painted like a 20-foot bump.
Well, actually, Douglas, I'm just here to talk to you about the new water pump. How much money have we got in the lodge, kitty?
I'm not telling you. And the reason I have a treasury is because I don't let anybody know how much is in there. That's what makes me the best treasurer this lodge has ever had.
So it's under $100?
Way under.
Well, then it doesn't matter whether we repair the pump or replace it. We can't afford to do either one.
Not from the kitty.
Well, we're not going to worry about money right now because it's time for Adventures with Bill. You don't worry about money with Bill. We're worried more about personal injury. Well, you get the idea. Bill got us out to the Possum Arena there, and he brought some garbage cans with him, and I wasn't quite sure what he had in mind. I wanted to line these up, and I thought maybe we were going to play Where's the Pee under the can. Well, can I? Okay, Bill, get your head out of there, Bill. Yeah. or whether they're going to play Where's the Pee Under the Can or the Pee Head Under the Can. But anyway, oh, gosh. I'm not sure Bill is familiar with how slippery ice can get when it's cold. Anyway, he got them all lined up there, and then he tried to explain to me what he was going to do. He reached into one of the barrels, pulls out his skates. So this was a clue. And he's gonna come skating along and then, ow, leap into the air. Oh, okay, he's gonna leap into the air and so this is basically your barrel jumping, your Olympic barrel jumping. And I was gonna wave the flag and make him go, and he's pretty excited about it. But then he's a natural athlete. So he went up, got his skates on, and I just sort of stood by the barrels with the flag at the ready, waiting for my cue. And he looked a little better with the skates on. So I figured, well, all right, let's. But then, oh, no, he's back up again. He's all right. These are his warm-up exercises. Kind of unusual, but then Bill's that kind of guy, isn't he? And this was really not working out so well. So Bill had another plan. Now he tried shoes. He tried. Oh, this is different. Cross country, I believe those are. Cross country barrel jumping. Up he comes. I'm getting the heck out of there. He's in the air and flying. Oh my gosh. Oh, Bill, Bill. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, there he is. There he is. Well, he seems all right. All I gotta do now is get him out to the end of the driveway by Tuesday. Everybody's getting involved in this water pump crisis. Buster's designed kind of a manual system, actually, for bringing water up from the lake. He got the idea from the movie Swiss Family Robinson, which just opened at the theater in town. It's on a double bill with Pillow Talk. All he needs is 7 bathtubs and a 3-inch thick clothesline. The clothesline we have. But now Douglas, the treasurer, as you know, he wants us all to just dig ourselves a new well. Well, we tried that before. We ended up with just a big open pit mine, and that eventually flooded, and that's how we got the big bay up at the north end.
Is that for sure? Like, the big bay? Really? Are you sure?
Sure as I'm standing here. Oh. Now, Helmut thought he had the water pump fixed, you know, but unfortunately he plugged it in, and now we need a new pump and a new fuse box. Nothing hurt except his pride and, of course, all of our aluminum wiring. But the unfortunate thing here is that Helmut has now taken that pump thing as a personal issue, and that's bad. The last time Helmut took something personally, we ended up having to reforest over 100 acres.
You know, I don't think we can rule out Murray's plan either. You know, he has a very impressive proposal for tonight's meeting. I helped him with the graphics. Oh, that's it? That's it? Oh, it's time for the meeting. Oh, D-Day. Oh, to pump or not to pump. That is the pulsating question. Come on, it's a meeting, Uncle Ray. Let's go. Come on, let's go.
Well, I'll be right back. This won't take too long. We're definitely not dealing with an unlimited attention span down there.
Thank you, Red. I'm happy to announce to everybody, Bill and I have fixed the pump.
Well, now, don't bother billing us because there's no money to pay for it.
Douglas, the last thing we need when the world's in trouble is an accountant. I'll have you know, Bill and I scrounged up every part for free. Mind you, you're going to have a little trouble starting your Nash.
Your filthy mitts touched my gremlin?
Oh, hang on. Let's remember, Bill and Helmut fixed this. It's not going to work.
That's an excellent point. I second that.
Yeah, shut up, Dwayne. That was a cruel and heartless thing to say, wasn't it, Murray?
Shut up, Harold.
Okay, let's shut up, Murray. Bill, fire up the pump. Hey, Bill, fire it up.
I'm sure it'll turn on eventually, but while we're waiting, I think I have something that might interest all of you. Dwayne?
Oh, thanks. No one's ever called me interesting before. Maybe it's my haircut or the fact that I've...
The drawing, Dwayne.
Oh.
Now, while we were arguing over whether we should fix the pump or replace it, I couldn't help get the feeling that, well, we just weren't thinking big enough. Well, so I decided we should invest in a big water turbine and put it in this. Dwayne?
What?
The drawing.
Oh, yeah. Murray's water theme park.
A water theme park, as Dwayne has so wonderfully preempted. Murray's Wild and Woolly Water Wonderland.
Huh? I wanted to call it Dwayne's Wet Spot.
Now, wait a minute. We can't afford that. We can't even afford this drawing.
The place is a gold mine. Oh, it'll be a magnet for tourists. We'll recruit new members and, well, we will get a lot of media attention, let me tell you.
Hold on a minute here, Murray. That's going to bring a lot of families up to the lodge.
We don't need that sort of thing right now. No,
forget it.
You know what you did last family here.
You don't need that.
I think what we have to do is the whole bunch of us have just got to do a little bit of thinking here for a minute or two and come up with some other brilliant ideas.
Oh, no, Uncle Red, you realize what you're asking here?
Look, think about it. I don't like this any more than you do, but I'm sure if we all put our minds together, something good will happen.
Someone's going to get hurt. Well...
Okay. Yeah. Excuse me a minute. Well, I think this is a perfect example of water, water everywhere, and not a thought to think. I don't know how religious you are, but if there is a greater power at work here, he either has a very unusual sense of humor or way too much time on his hands. Anyway, if my wife is watching, I'll be coming straight home after the meeting, and I'm feeling lucky tonight, so why don't you leave the television on? So, until next time, on behalf of myself, Harold, and the whole gang up here at Possum Lodge, keep your stick on the ice.
This is the best. Oh, this is such a good idea that I got. I've got it.